Dr. Gitanshu. Okay, I'm the convener for the Institute Innovation Council, and today we are here for the first meeting of the Institute Innovation Council. Okay, today I welcome everybody. Our president for the ISE is Dr. Manjula Jain, who is also the Associate Dean Academics for TMU, and all of the newly gathered members here. So now I would request ma'am to address the gathering and brief us about the ISE.
I'm really happy to see that maximum of the members are here, and this is a good start for all of us to have this innovation council here at the level of university. So this might be a pertinent question in all of your mind, that why we all gathered here and what is the purpose, what is the objective of constituting this committee, this council. So let me give you a brief up on this. This is an initiative of Ministry of Education. The Institution Innovation Council comes under the MHRD Innovation Cell. As you all are aware that our Honorable Prime Minister is focusing more on the innovation and the innovation ecosystem, and particularly at the higher level education institutions. This is being a buzzword for the last many years. So in 2018, this initiative was taken up by the MHRD, and higher education institutions were required to form an innovation council at the university level as well as at the college levels. So our university and a few of the colleges, they were registered as the IIC, that is Institution Innovation Council. And we have at present around 7 colleges of the universities. They are registered as the IIC at the college level, with the ID being given by the Ministry of Education. And our university was also registered in the year 2018, in the month of October. And the constitution was as per the mandate given by the MOE IIC, that is Ministry of Education and Institution Innovation Council. And you might be aware of various words that have been, you know, highlighting these days, that is incubation centers, innovation centers. And based on these only, our level of efficiency is being rated in NAC and NERF. In NAC, we have this kind of requirement, that do you have any kind of incubation center, innovation cell at your university. So it was a minus point at our end, that in spite of having so many activities being done at the college level and at the portal of IIC MOE, your names, as per received from the concerned principals of different colleges, you have been accommodated, you have been constituted as a part of this council, and your name, your details has been updated on the portal. Now, as per this IIC, we are required to do certain functions. Those functions would include, I should read aloud here, otherwise we can have the depiction of what this IIC will be performing, and this has the representation of faculty members, of expert members from some external environment than university, and the students of our university. So these are the three components of this IIC. Now these are the functions that we have to conduct, or they have to be obliged to conduct various innovation, IPR and entrepreneurship related activities prescribed by MHRD's IC in time bound fashion, success stories, organize periodic workshops, seminars, interactions with entrepreneurs, investors, professionals, and create a mentor pool for student innovators, network with peers and national entrepreneurship development organizations, create an institution's innovation portal to highlight innovative projects carried out by institutions, faculty and students, organize hackathons, idea competition, mini challenges and etc. with the involvement of industries. We have to rush up, we have to, you know, on our toes. So in order to at least complete, because we are fortunate enough in that sense that we have to conduct only 5 to 7 activities. And this is the university council. So I think when colleges are able to do that, we at the university level should be able to do that. And with your efforts, solving an ideation workshop, exposure and field visit for problem identification. Now we know that we cannot conduct this field visit because we are having this time where we can be relaxed. We can leave this activity because this is elective. Like pitching workshop and linkage of innovators with innovation ambassadors. panel discussion on Atmanirbhar Bharat. That will be a resource person has been identified, and he is from Bharati Vidyapeeth University. And then we have idea and proof of concept pitching and validation. Now there are certain activities which seem to be very very ticklish. How we are going to do that? So here one of those activities is idea. As we do in management or in any other field of study, that any innovative idea if you have in your mind, those ideas have to be depicted either in the form of a poster, or that can be depicted in the form of a concrete model that you have. So first of all, that idea has to be invited, and then the proof of that concept has to be developed and validated. In terms of when we say that convocation can be conducted not only in offline mode but in online mode also. These I shared earlier also, IPR, internship, startup, social media, innovation. In that we have the option that we can add up to 10 students in each category. But we have, in order to have a the number that we can manage at the meeting level, so we have kept only one student or maximum two students in a particular activity. But if you think that you can add up more number of the students, you are free to add up. Just make a list of that and submit that to us. We'll update it on the